everyone. Now, today I am here to teach you the diagram of human brain. Right? Now, human brain, as you know, is a part of the central nervous system. And human brain has got three parts. First part is the forebrain. Second is midbrain. And third is the hind brain. But in this video, we will be concentrating only on the parts of the brain and the diagram. Functions I will be giving you in the next video. Now, how to start to draw this diagram? We have started with the midbrain. See how? This is a structure like this. Start drawing it along with me. The way we take, see, we write two like this. And you have to give a slight curve over here. And sink it here. And throw it as a table. After that, I'll just like this. And after that, from here, complete this tail. So this is the midbrain. Above this midbrain, you draw a lobe-like structure like this. And now start moving along the boundary. And here you make one loop, another loop. And after that, keep coming along with the boundary. And here, you draw a three-lobed structure. Just look at my hand. One, two, and three. And coming back again like this. This part will become the part of spinal cord. After that, what you do is you can complete this as a 3D structure. I am visualizing like this. It's a half cut lemon, and this is how we draw the 3D structure of this lemon. Same here, and complete it with these lines. And you remember when in childhood we used to draw the grass like this? Similar structure you have to draw here also, like grass. After this, come to this part where we had left. Keep moving along with the boundary. And just above this part of the midbrain, draw a one lobe structure and another a drooping lobe structure. Now pay attention. This is midbrain. This part is the base of the midbrain. Now taking it as a roof and complete it like this. One lobe, another lobe, and one another, and complete it like this. Or this part, in the middle of which it is the tail of the midbrain, and this part is nothing but your spinal cord. I'll come to all these parts. Now this part of the brain, this midbrain, it is the hypothalamus. It is the hypothalamus. I will write it over here because I need to complete the brain diagram on this side. Hypothalamus. And just above in front of hypothalamus, this lobe structure that we drew, this is nothing but this is the pituitary gland. This also I will take above. Pituitary gland. These two are the endocrine glands which are associated with the brain. Next, now what we are going to do is See the spot. The spot. Name it as, I will name it as P. Below the spot, M. And this trilobe structure, C. What is this P, M, C? I am writing the first letters of all these three parts. This is pons. This is medulla. And this trilobe structure is cerebellum. Cerebellum. And all these three parts together constitute the hind brain. It is the hind brain. Now coming to, we have drawn midbrain, we have drawn hind brain. It consists of three parts. Now we will come to the forebrain. How to complete this? Now you see, just below here, start drawing this large structure like this. This is the largest part of the brain, that is forebrain. The brain is protected by protective layers, three layers called meninges. Meninges, and these meninges, they enclose a cerebrospinal fluid which is protective in nature, which protects the brain and of course the spinal cord against shocks or any kind of injury. So I will complete this meninges. And outside this meninges, the brain is enclosed with a bony structure called skull. This part is the skull and it is also known as the cranium. This is also known as a cranium. Now this largest part of the brain is the forebrain. This is forebrain and it is also known as cerebrum. This is also known as cerebrum. So we have completed all three parts, hindbrain, midbrain, forebrain, and now what are we left with? The folds present inside the forebrain. It is this part of the brain, it consists of large number of folds. Have you seen inside the walnut, when we open the walnut, it is in the form of different folds. So brain is also like that. Now this forebrain, how to draw this? The folds. Now see how I am making these semicircles. Here I am removing this labeling, these lines, so that I can complete this diagram. Here we will draw a structure like W. And from here W, I'll make just two or three inverted commas like structure. Right? And now here, we can bring these structures like this. Main idea is to draw the folds. Now here, just an S-like structure. And you can bring it like this. The main idea is to make the folds like this. So these are the gyri and cell type of human brain. So let's have a quick review. The brain consists of three parts, forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. And we started this diagram with this midbrain. Right? And hind brain, three parts, pons, medulla, cerebellum. These are the three parts of hind brain. And next comes the forebrain. Largest part of the brain is the forebrain and is also known as cerebrum. Note down the difference. This is cerebrum and this is cerebellum. Now this brain is covered with the protective coverings called meninges, and these meninges, they enclose a cavity that is known as cerebrospinal cavity, which includes a fluid called cerebrospinal fluid, which protects the brain against mechanical shocks and injury. And outside the meninges, the brain is covered with the bony structure called skull. So this is all for the diagram of the human brain, and in the next video, of course, we'll be doing the functions of different parts of the brain. So thank you for watching.